Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Counting down to pre-open, we have Mr. Tulsan still with us. Mr. Tulsan, good morning. I wanted your thoughts on the two mid-cap IT companies coming out with numbers today, NIIT Tech and Mindtree. Both have done remarkably well through the last 1 year. Your thoughts?
See, Anuj, ahead of the results, it is risky to take a call. And you are right that, you know, both have done quite well. And in fact, that's is what is seen into the reflecting into the share price also. So better that, you know, we take a call on the results which have already been declared, maybe like Scient and all that, which have not, in fact, cheered the market, or maybe nuclear software. But I won't be taking a call ahead of the numbers on Mindtree and NIIT Tech both.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, they are also ruling very high. So that's something to watch out for. Well, it's about half a minute for the markets to open. So we might as well pull up how the Asian markets are, pull up the dollar index as well. It's still above 95. That could be just a mild spot of bother. And of course, pull up SGX Nifty to check what kind of cues we are getting. Well, they're very green cues that are coming from the Asian markets as well. SGX Nifty is in step, a third of a percent higher. The rupee had a decently strong day, so let's see whether the strength can continue. A little difficult considering that the dollar has been a little stronger overnight. Okay, that's the market opening. The first rates are slightly in the red, but I guess we have to look more at stocks like, okay, it's green now. 1% high actually, 11,120, above 11,100. Maybe we want to pull up Z Entertainment and perhaps even Federal Bank. Those are the stocks that we should be closely watching today. Z Entertainment numbers came after market hours. And that's Federal Bank continuing to charge higher, about 3%. And that Z Entertainment numbers just welcomed by the market, at least as of now. We'll do one thing, we'll allow the markets to settle.
Yeah, 150 point higher on Nifty because of free credit on HDFC. I think obviously that will correct. So we'll wait for that to correct.
HDFC Bank can be higher because they have allotted shares to HDFC at a slightly higher than expected price.
Exactly. By the way, a couple of these PSU banks are looking quite interesting. IOB is up 18% in pre-open. Don't know if that's how it will pan out. PNB also up about 10%. Let's wait for these rates to settle. Z Entertainment would be the stock that would react to numbers. 2.5% higher is what we have. There's a mid-cap stock, Setco Automotive, which has been making some moves over the last couple of days. Interesting stock. Let's just pull out that chart again. Yesterday also it was up quite a bit. And today also in pre-open it has some volume. Setco is the stock, SETCO, that we're talking about. That one is quite interesting, 5% higher.
Okay. Well, we have Surabhi also joining us. Surabhi, any important stocks that you are watching now?
I also had my eye again on a couple of these movers. Syntex Industries has reported numbers. Syntex Plastics had a horrendous show for the first quarter. Industries in the pre-open is up about 4% on the back of those numbers. Tata Sponge is up 6%. Nigel was telling us that was decent performance as well. So these are some of the additional names on the list. We don't have a rate on the milk stocks, Lata. And I think that's something that the market will see, whether there will be any follow-through at all after this 15-20% kind of spike that we were seeing on the export incentive news that came
yesterday. I was bringing up that point because we also have a guest joining us on the matter. Remember, the dairy space was abuzz yesterday because the government decided to give 10% export incentive for dairy products. R.G. Chandramogan, the chairman and managing director of Hatsun Agro, has joined us on the phone line to tell us whether this addresses the problem and whether it impacts his business. Good morning, Mr. Chandramogan. Do you export at all?
I have been exporting for the last 2.5 years. We have not been exporting because the international prices were too low.
Okay, what percentage were you exporting?
Earlier, I was exporting about 7% of our sales as exports. Okay. And now, we were also given an APEDA award.
Okay. With this 10%, will you resume exports?
No. Probably this 10% has got no relevance to the present issue. This international market is at 134. And this 10% is too late and too little. This is something like dousing the forest fire with a bucket of water. This is not going to help the industry at all.
So, sir, then what is required? You said 134. I mean, is that the prevailing milk price in the international market? Just trying to understand if
New Zealand is the biggest exporter and they are charging 134.
This is okay. Dollars per something?
No, no, I'm converting it into rupee and say, I'm saying it. 1,900 plus is the dollar.
Okay, okay. So,
so I'm saying this is yesterday's price in New Zealand, 134.
Okay. And now, what is the prevailing price in India, and with the export incentive, what will it work out to for you?
See, the cost of milk powder in India will be about 180.
Oh, 80. Okay.
So, even if you are going to give 10% discount and all that, this is not going to work, number one. Mm. Number two, price, we have not been in international market. The price has to be a little less than New Zealand prices to get an entry again.
Okay.
So, you can't charge anything more than 125. Even if you are going to get 12.5, this is not going to be of any use. The only best alternative is, we have got stocks of 2 lakh tons. This has to be given to SAR countries free, or African countries free. This will douse the situation. Automatically, the prices will resume in Maharashtra. Mm-hmm. There is no need for subsidy of different nature and all that.
Okay.
And this has to be done, otherwise the problem cannot be solved.
Okay, so you're basically saying, I mean, there is a wide gap of over 50 rupees in terms of a competitive international price and the price at which you are today. So this additional stock that you mentioned, sir, this 2 lakh tons, this right now is being exported?
No, no. 2 lakh tons has not been exported so far. Now, Gujarat government has announced 50 rupees per kg.
Mm.
Now, over and above that 10%, they will get about 62 rupees now.
Mm.
And Gujarat, Maharashtra is also announcing export subsidy and all that. But probably the problem is, the immediately the market will not open up. Maybe these particular areas will be benefited.
Mm.
As far as we are concerned, we are basically brand sellers and not much of a milk powder producer.
Mm.
We produce our excess milk into milk powder. We have reduced this portfolio drastically to see to that that probably we are only containing to the core business of milk, ice cream, curd, and other branded items.
Okay. What is the at cost, sir? I mean, why can't you sell it at a cheaper rate in India itself?
No, no. Probably, see, cheaper rate in India, if you are going to sell it, you have to book a loss for this particular division.
Okay. So, you now, mean 180 rupees is cost and you can't sell it below that?
No, 180 is the cost.
Okay.
And whatever the subsidy you give, you will not be able to sell more than 110 rupees in the international market.
Okay.
Because 134 is quoted, this will be compensated by this 10%.
No, that was my point. You know, therefore, if you could sell at, you know, 170 or 150 in the Indian market, will that work for you at all? You think you book a loss?
It will work only when the excess stock is moving out of the country. This balance will come.
Okay.
Excess stock, once when it is there, you don't have a market here.
Okay.
Okay, so what is the, in the domestic market, what is the price trend and what is the expectation over the next few months? This 180, is this likely to sustain?
No, actually 180 is my cost. Maharashtra cost may be 160 because the prices are lower there.
Okay.
But still, for them also, it's a losing proposition.
Okay. Now there is a milk farmer strike starting yesterday. Is that having an impact?
No, as far as we are concerned, we are not impacted, though we have collected milk in Maharashtra. But it is a part of our bucket. And right now, we are not affected. But this will definitely affect the industry. And Karnataka government is giving subsidy of 1,300 crores every year.
Okay.
And reducing the price by subsidizing 5 rupees. Okay. What is happening is, the private corporates are taxed and they are given SOPs. This is not going to be right for the industry in the long run. We have to just balance it out, and we have to scrap these subsidies and bring a long-term solution. And this particular short-term solution can only be giving this as a gift to African countries and get the balance out. Automatically, Maharashtra prices will resume.
Okay.
This is the only way out, in my opinion.
Kill the stock. All right.
Yes.
Point taken, Mr. Chandramogan. Thank you very much for joining us with those details. So that's a wide difference. And a tall subsidy that has to be expected. Mr. Tulsian, any comments at all on this sector?
See, Lata, the problem is that there is no export market in spite of whatever I've heard the CMD of Hatsun, you know, and if you really take a call, in fact, this is a situation what we have been seeing in case of sugar also, that the domestic market is all, you know, flooded with the stock here, but there is no domestic consumption, even if you bring down the prices. So until the subsidy gets increased, and that's what I have said, that if you really see the kind of surge in the share prices, Prabhat Dairy moved up by 13-14% yesterday, the other milk stock, I don't think that this is the basis or this is a way one should really plunge into. And that's what I've said, that I will remain cautious, because unless until you have the clarity on the export potential, because whatever that CMD has said, that, you know, the 2 lakh ton has to move out of the country, because we are all sitting on the excess or the ample milk powder, which is not having the domestic market also, irrespective of the cost. So these are the situation faced by the dairy shares, and I don't think that one should deal. And again, you know, you cannot take a generalized call, because Hatsun Agro, in fact, what I've hinted for 2 or 3 good quality stocks are Hatsun Agro, definitely in that category. We have seen the fate of quality. I can't put Nestle in the same category, because they won't be exporting anything from here. Mm. So if you really take the overall scenario for this sector, I don't think that you have comfort on the stocks like maybe Prabhat Dairy or maybe Parag Mill kind of stocks at the current valuations.
Okay, Mr. CNB, thank you on that note. Thanks a lot for joining us. We'll talk to you in closing bell, of course. The pre-open has settled 100 points higher on the Bank Nifty, 50 points higher on the Nifty, 87 higher on the mid-cap. So looks like it's going to be a good start. Ashwini, your thoughts on market opening? You won't be chasing this gap up? Ashwini? Okay, we'll get to Ashwini in a bit. Sudarshan, your thoughts on how the pre-open has settled?
Well, the pre-open is where the SGX was indicating, and there is a trade. If once it crosses 11,080 and stays there, that's a breakout trade, and I would take it. And the second trade is much easier. It corrects to 11,020, 11,025, 11,020. That's a dip trade. But at current, as the market opens, there is no trade.
Fair point. We will just come back to all of you with more questions. Let's put one more important set of cues on the table, the commodity cues. Manisha Gupta is joining in. Good morning, Manisha.
Morning, Lata. Thank you for that. Well, some more pressure is what we have seen in the crude oil prices. Lower lows being created, down 10% in last 1 week itself. And the latest trigger comes in from the U.S. weekly inventories, where there's a buildup in the crude inventories and the gasoline inventories as well. Markets also are looking at increase in supplies from Iraq. They have exported the highest since November 2017, and that seems to be adding to some pressure as well. The Goldman Sachs and Platt reports, which have come in this week, do suggest that the crude oil prices will more or less maintain between $70 to $80 per barrel, with spikes on either side not ruled out. So as of now, of course, we are trading on the lower side of the range here. Markets also would be wanting clarity on increase in supplies from Saudi Arabia, the U.S. Strategic Petroleum Reserve and Libya, etc. So quite a bit of an uncertainty, but clearly it is the hedge funds and the money managers unwinding their long positions. That is one major reason that you have seen the slide in crude oil prices. The slide also has come in for the gold prices, trading at a one-year lows for that. Silver also has continued to decline. The physical buying, as we have been talking, has been absent. And the strength in U.S. dollar, the Powell testimony, putting the state of economy as positive is what's weighing on to this space. Another positive, of course, for the Indian stock markets could be the metal space, where we have seen good buying in Shanghai today. The steel prices have gained up for a second straight day. Iron ore prices trading at a 2-week highs. And almost everything in the base metal space is a 0.5% on the higher side, whether it's nickel, copper, aluminum, all of these metals are trading in the positive.
All right, Manisha, thanks a lot for that. Ashwini is back with us. Ashwini, I wanted your thoughts on the pre-open. You won't be chasing this gap up, or do you think it can be chased?
See, we are going to open exactly at the upper boundaries. Mm. So because I trade intraday and I'm open to taking swings, so the first trade for me will be to short and see what happens. If I get, maybe yesterday's close back, that will be a good enough trade, because my sense is that you will not cross this with a gap up. It would have been a different issue if yesterday's rally were to happen today and Nifty was starting at 11,060, but I think we are overstretched. At least one jerk down, 25-30 points on the Nifty can easily happen.
Okay.
Ashwini, what about the call, 9-10 stock call?
See, Berger Paint is a buy with a stop of 309, target of 325.
Okay. Well, just for information, the bond yields have opened even lower. The first rate was 7.71. Then I think went to 7.72. That's always a bit bullish for banking stocks, PSU banks, NBFCs. So just put that now, 7.72. So that could be attractive in terms of the cost of capital moving down. We are starting about 0.5% higher. Mitesh, any further stocks that you want to watch?
Yeah, Lata, I think I would be watching Reliance very, very closely. I think, you know, it gave a 1-2 day kind of a dip and yesterday moved up. I think if it sustained above 1100, then we might be looking at a higher target over there.
Okay, Sudarshan, I know you don't like PSU banks, but which is the best PSU bank to trade, say, intraday or positionally?
Well, State Bank is the best bank, but I don't think you mean that as a PSU.
Yeah.
So it would be Canara Bank. Canara Bank is the best today.
Okay. Well, actually, the capital announcements indicated that Corporation Bank and IOB have got a slightly better deal. Ashwini, is there a day trade?
Where?
Corporation, IOB, Andhra, Allahabad, any of them?
Well, they are going to lose this capital also, so I don't think this is a big issue.
But they won't lose it in a day. I meant for the day, intraday.
I don't think these are great trades to do.
Okay, well, they're just starting about 8% higher.
That's exactly what I was going to ask Ashwini as well, but I guess just 20 odd seconds to go. Anything on tech, Ashwini? Anything fresh? I mean, yesterday, mid-cap tech was looking a little excited again. Just 20 seconds to go.
See, NIT Tech, Tata Elxsi, all of these guys could do well.
Okay. Well, at the moment, it's Sun Pharma that's doing well, and so is Infosys, seeing a bit of a buying. Oil stocks continue to gain, and Asian Paints, in terms of paint companies, I would assume Berger's also higher, but we'll come to that in a bit.